Hey there, today I'm going to show you how to target the Windows subsystem for Linux 2 from Visual Studio Code. Now, if you've never installed WSL 2 before, first thing you want to do is go to aka.ms/WSL2install. This will give you all the necessary information you need to enable the features in your operating system, to go and download your favorite Linux distribution from the Microsoft Store, everything you need to get set up. I have already gone through all of these instructions, so I've got Debian installed alongside, you know, of course, the most important applications like KRSA and APT and, you know, everything which you're used to from just running a Debian system normally. Now, if I want to target this from VS Code, what I want to do is go ahead and go to the extensions and find this Remote WSL extension. If I go and open this up, I have already installed this, but you'll be able to install it just using these buttons here, just like any other extension. And it will give you a bunch of information on getting started with targeting WSL. Once we have installed this, one way we can open up a connection is this remote window button. This gives us a bunch of options. You know, we can pick our distribution if we have multiple ones installed, which I do. I have Ubuntu installed in WSL 1 and Debian in WSL 2. So I can go ahead and open a folder. This will, just in a second, there we go, get a file picker. Like I said, I got Debian and Ubuntu, and the whole file system is just mounted inside Windows, so I can go and have a look. I'm going to go ahead and open my expected implementation, and we can give a try at building it and testing it and making sure IntelliSense works, everything you might be used to. Another way of getting a connection into WSL is just opening up our Debian here and saying code and then the folder you want to open. And this will go ahead and open up Visual Studio Code inside Windows and connect into WSL, which is what's happening right now. It's starting up the server inside Debian and then connecting to it. And then this is going to take a little while to load up because it's doing a whole lot of stuff. It's starting up that server and connecting to it. It's then also going to have to get all of our extensions, like I'm using CMake for this project here. It's going to have to configure CMake. Configuring CMake for this project will take a little bit of time because that pulls down some files like catch2 from the internet. But in a minute, we just got our syntax highlighting, which is nice. And this is going to activate all our extensions. So this will be when it'll say, hey, this is a CMake project and we have the CMake extension installed. So we're going to have to, there we go, set up CMake, find any local kits, which are our tool chains essentially, like different versions of GCC or Clang or whatever. And now this is going to go and configure our project. So CMake will be, you know, looking at our CMake lists and pulling down any necessary files. You can see this is running inside Linux. This is not giving us anything in our Windows file system. This is all inside Debian. So it's going to configure. When it does configure, then we should have all the ability to build our project, to run the tests, to get IntelliSense, everything you might expect. So this is just going to configure for a second. There we go. That's it. Configured and generated. And now if I hit F7, then this will build my tests for me inside WSL. Starting build, running CMake build. You can see this is saying to do on 6 threads. And we're going to get our tests built, and then we'll be able to run them from within Visual Studio Code. Building, linking. And done. So now if I hit Control-Shift-P, I can use CMake run tests to run the tests. And there's a whole bunch of different test files. There we go. It realized I didn't have to do any work and run the test, and they passed. And if we go ahead and go here, we should be able to see our IntelliSense completion. There we go. Got and then and assign and has value. It's just like you would if you were writing our code natively. Then when we're finished, if we want to go back to doing native development, we can just hit that button again and close the remote connection, and then we'll be back to developing inside Windows. So that's everything you need to get started with targeting WSL 2 from Visual Studio Code. Please do check out Pure Virtual C++ on the 3rd of May for more C++ content. We're going to have more things about CMake, C++20 features, a whole lot of great stuff, so I'll hopefully see you there.